Good morning. Today, August 29, 2021, Sunday. This is Indian Express, published from Thiruvananthapuram. Daily newspaper here. We can see the main headings. Kills two high-profile ISISK leaders in drone strike. Evacuation to end soon. US strikes back. Warns of more terror attacks. Thiruvananthapuram CM calls for calm, counts on vaccine. Claims and counterclaims. Police beat up farmers who headed to BJP meeting venue. Chandigarh. Five Tamil Nadu labourers held in Mysuru gang rape case. Pink police humiliate young girl dad in public and uniformity in holy mass preached to appeal to Pope. This is the front page. The detailed news from the front page, already I put another video, so I am going to the second page for details. This is a English lesson from Kerala. Nasrullah Mambroil's blog literature.org that discusses theory and criticism is recommended by over 200 universities across globe, reports Amiya Mittal, Kozhikode. More than 9 million hits across 200 countries, recommended by over 200 universities across the globe, including Oxford, Duke and King's College London. Thousands of paid audio lectures made available for free. Access to 16 e-magazines, including the New Yorker and the Times Literary Supplement, with many more such features. The academic world of English literature is tipping its hat to the blog literarynews.org, created by a Malayali. Literarynews, literarynews.org, literarynews.org, created by a Malayali. Nasrullah Mambroil, a guest lecturer in English at the NAM College Kallikandi near Panur, launched the blog 5 years ago when he stumbled upon a lack of resources while preparing for the NET examination. It is too difficult to an Indian research student to get in international materials without paying a hefty amount, says the 32-year-old from Vanimel near Kuttiyadi in Kozhikode district. Students have to shell out lakhs to individually assess academic repositories like Jester or Springer, or to subscribe to international publications. I found this gap huge and tried to address it in the form of a blog, confusing on English, focusing on English literature and criticism. And he has set a target. I want to make global resource materials available to the needy free of charge. Okay, thank you. Fisheries Department rolls out application for quality products. The Fisheries Department on Friday rolled out the Mimi Fish app that will approve retail customers with the option to purchase quality fish and other allied products. The project conceived by the State Coastal Area Development Corporation is being implemented with the cooperation of the Central Fisheries Technology Institute and Society for Advanced Technologies and Management. Under the project, MIMI retail shops and home delivery facility will be made available across the state in the later stage. The consumers can either make use of the application book fish and other value-added products to get them delivered at their doorsteps, or can directly purchase them from the retail outlets. Nadapuram Panchayat offers tax reduction to promote scientific waste management. Ajit Kannan, Kozhikode. In a novel bid to tackle the issue of waste maintenance by encouraging people to adhere to scientific methods of managing bio-waste, Nadapuram Panchayat has begun up with a slew of initiative, including tax reduction and provision of privilege cards to families that make use of the waste management programs launched by the local body. We are on a mission to convert our panchayat into a waste-free zone to find a lasting solution for waste menace. Waste menace, we have launched a slew of projects using scientific methods to dispose all types of waste, said V.V. Muhammad Ali, panchayat president. As per the current system, a 44-member Harida Karma Sena is dealing with the plastic waste maintenance by collecting all types of non-combustible solid waste, including plastic, electronic, glass and rubber waste from houses and shops. An amount of rupees 50 is charged from households and rupees 100 from shops for one neck of waste as service charge. Meanwhile, to manage bio waste, the local body has implemented schemes to set up a ring compost units and biogas plants at homes. More flight services to Europe on card Sial. The Cochin International Airport Limited Sial has initiated discussions with major airlines to improve direct flight services to European countries. There is a huge demand for direct services to London and Frankfurt, and efforts are on to lure airlines operators to launch direct services to these cities. As an initial step, CL has a waived parking and landing fees for airlines operating in the European sector. The airport handles around 1.85 lakh passengers in Kochi, Europe sector a year, and on an average nearly 900 passengers transit through Kochi to European destinations. Tiger test estimation in state to begin in September 3. The Forest Department has kick-started the All India Tiger Estimation Exercise in Kerala. The installation of camera traps in forest areas will begin on September 3rd. The tiger estimation is spearheaded by the National Tiger Conservation Authority in association with the State Forest Department and Wildlife Institute in India. Fisheries Department roll out application for quality products. Your Honor, up for a fight. Kollam. P. R. Omal Gopal was 18 when he met with a two-wheeler accident on the Angel Iyer stretch in 2010. A Kerala Law Academy student then, he was returning from the Kottarekera Ganapati temple before leaving for a moot court competition in Bangalore. His world came trembling down and the remained in a coma for 16 days. Over the past 11 years, he has undergone 15 surgeries. 15 surgeries after begins a coma, Arumal Krishnan is now ready to argue in court, reports Cynthia Chandran. Let's say news from New Delhi. Upholding the dignity of the woman, CM Yogi launches Mission Shakti 3.30. The highlights of the Mission Shakti 3.0 is Mission Shakti will always remain at the top of the agenda of UP government, Yogi Adityanath. Mission Shakti 3.0, CM Yogi pledges to protect the dignity of women of the state. Mission will prove it to be milestone in providing the security, dignity and self-reliance to women. Rs 30.12 crore transferred online into accounts of 1.55 lakh girls under the Kenya Sumangala Yojana. More than 10,000, the project is Kanya Sumangala Yojana, not Kenya. More than 10,000 police women made beat officers on the occasion. 75 outstanding women honored under the program Asadika Amritam also for their net worth contribution in various fields. Similarly, 75 women honored were honored in every district. The beginning of the news is choosing auspicious occasion of Raksha Bandhan to further the sense of safety, security and dignity among women, Uttar Pradesh Chief Minister Yogi Adityanath launched the third phase of the ambitious Mission Shakti in the state in presence of Governor Anandi Ben Patel and Union Minister Finance and Corporate Affairs Nirmala Sitharaman. This is the mission. Yogi Adityanath loves women's SHGS. State government has managed to not only provide employment but also raise the living standards of rural women through the SHGS, which were roped in various fields, including manufacture of PPE kits, masks, school uniforms, and milk production. Chief Minister Yogi Adityanath has been a great admirer of women's self-help groups for their role in awakening among the rural women and transferring rural economies. He has also been appreciative of their presence across the state through their crucial role in helping the government in its battle against the novel coronavirus pandemic. The CM, who recently transferred over rupees 88 crore to more than 40,000 women self-help groups and 2,606 other SHGS from the Revolving Fund and Community Investment Fund respectively, under the State Rural Livelihood Mission, spoke very highly of them. He asserted that the state government had managed to reach out to 52 lakh families through formation of 4.8 lakh SHGS. Stating the Prime Minister Narendra Modi's target of economic emancipation of poor women, Yogi said that the state government had managed to not only provide employment but also raise the living standards of rural women through the SHGS, which were roped in various fields, including manufacture of PPE kits, masks, school uniforms, besides engaging them in milk production. UP State Rural Livelihood Mission empowers rural women. The women of the self-help groups formed under supervision of the mission have been apprised of welfare programs run by the Yogi Adityanath government and also about the helpline numbers such as 1090, 1076, 1098, 108, 102, 112 and others. UP holds 75 women in all 75 districts. Assuring once again the state government stands firmly to safeguard women's rights, the third and entirely new phase of Mission Shakti does not only focus on their security, education and dignity, but also makes them self-reliant and self-dependent while recognizing their contribution in different fields of life. In a bid to encourage women, Uttar Pradesh government honored 75 women in 75 districts of the state, women honored for their extraordinary achievements in the field of women empowerment work during COVID-19 pandemic and contribution towards the development of Uttar Pradesh included medical practitioners, health workers, members of self-help groups, entrepreneurs and women belonging to voluntary organizations. Apart from coinciding with the launch of the third phase of Mission Shakti, this also linked them combined with the Azadi Ka Amrit Mahotsav being observed since August 15. Reflecting upon the importance of the third phase of Mission Shakti, the Director of Women's Welfare Department, Manoj Roy, stated that earlier two phases of the mission had yielded positive results in creating an environment of safety, dignity and empowerment of women. Various programs, campaigns and events organized in carrying out the mission also help connect women and girls with various schemes of the government. PM Ujwala Yojana relaunched to provide a free LPG connection. Prime Minister's Ujwala Yojana, making a fresh attempt to safeguard the woman's dignity and health, the Prime Minister Modi has relaunched the Ujjala Yojana for free LPG connections in UP, launching the Pradhan Mantri Ujjala Yojana 2.0. PM Modi virtually handed over free LPG connections to women beneficiaries in Mahabad district 5 years ahead of the 75th Independence Day of the country. Chief Minister Adityanath handed over the documents to the woman on behalf of the Prime Minister. Union Petroleum and Natural Gas Minister Hardeep Singh Puri was also present on the occasion. Congratulating beneficiaries, the Prime Minister said that the scheme has illuminated and changed the life of a number of women and their families in the country. It may be recalled that the first phase of the scheme was started in 2016 from Ballia. In the first phase of the scheme, 8 crore poor, Dalit, deprived, backward, tribal families were given free gas connections during the COVID period. The scheme has benefited crores of people. Now to laborers do not have to wander here and there for address proofs. All they need to do, give a self-declaration of address and get the gas connection. NHAI fame won toll collection parties to intensify protests from tomorrow. We will discuss with the higher officials on further steps to be taken, says NHAI project director. Thiruvananthapuram, with the National Highways Authority of India, NHAI, making it clear during a high-level meeting in Saturday that it will go ahead with the collection at the newly opened toll plaza on the Kazhakootam Kar Road NH66 bypass. Political parties have decided to show their protest from Monday. IT department to fast track development projects for parks in state. Thiruvananthapuram, the Department of Electronics and IT has initiated efforts to fast track the developmental projects undergoing at various IT parks in the state. A high level meeting of top officials was held in Technopark, Thiruvananthapuram on Saturday to review and assess the ongoing projects in the state. Biswan Singha, Principal Secretary, Department of Electronics and IT, who presided over the meeting, said a decision has been taken to further strengthen the coordination between IT parks and the department to meet the industry expectations. Kerala IT Park CEO Jonam Thomas and senior official from the IT department and Technopark also attended the meeting. The ongoing huge developmental project in Technopark and Kochi Infopark have attracted more investors and global IT firms to the state. Several companies have already expressed interest in expanding their operations to Kerala, and all the infrastructure developments across the IT parks are in line with the requirements of multinationals. Body of missing student recovered. The body of a 23-year-old engineering final year student who went missing in Seattle couple Saturday along with the friend while bathing on Friday was recovered from the sea near Perinkulam. Postponement of B.Tech exams leaves students in the lurch. Gang of four dues forest men pretending as PMO staff to held. Under protest of PM security personnel, they stayed at Vettathur Watchtower. Pulpalli police arrested two members of a gang of four who duped forest officials under the pretext that they were officers in the Prime Minister's office. Thiruvananthapuram natives Rajesh Puthanveed, 34, and Praveen Vadakethil, 27, were caught on Friday from their residence in Thiruvananthapuram. On July 25th this year, Rajesh and Praveen, along with Deepak Pichand and M. Girish, under the protest of being security personnel of the Prime Minister, stayed in the Vettathur Watchtower in Chedalayam Forest Range. Forest officials delivered food free of cost and arranged for a watcher for the safety of the gang. Note for rupees 455.89 crore, project to build 11,011 houses. Guruvayur Devaswam case demonetized notes worth 38,000 as offering hundis. Even after 4 years of demonetization, Guruvayur Devaswam continues to receive banned currency notes of 1,500 as offerings through hundis. When the hundis were opened, recently banned
currency notes of rupees 1000 and rupees 500 totaling of